In this week's Tuesday tutorial, we're going to see how we can make content-aware fill in Photoshop even better. I'm Dave Cross, and you may have found sometimes when you're using content-aware fill that as great as it can be, sometimes it picks from the wrong area because you make a selection, you say content-aware fill, and it randomly picks some nearby area to use as its fill, and sometimes it does a great job, but other times it really doesn't, and the only alternative is to undo and try again, and unfortunately sometimes after two or three tries it still doesn't work very well. So here's a nice little trick where you're trying to do something with content-aware fill and you can really narrow down the choices for this effect to get a better result. So here's an example. Here's a photo that I had worked on in Lightroom, and when I affected the lens distortion, it came in with these transparent areas. So I'm thinking, well, I'll just take my lasso tool and select this area, and then go to fill and do content aware and click OK. And hopefully it'll do a pretty good job, but unfortunately it's using part of the church as its reference, and I could try undoing and trying it again, but the likelihood is, no matter how many times I try it, that's just because there's so little information, that's what I'm gonna get. So what I can do is I can basically tell Photoshop, these are the only areas that I wanna use. In other words, I wanna exclude certain parts of the photograph, so when content-aware fill looks for nearby areas, it won't see the wrong areas. So the solution is actually relatively simple, and that is just make a rough selection around anything you don't want content-aware fill to be able to use, like the church here. I also realized when I tried this before that there's a little element here that when I tried to content-aware fill, it repeated this exact same object, so I'm going to include this in here as well. So now what all I need to do is hide this from content-aware fill, saying don't use these areas. So we're going to do that is by using a layer mask. Now normally when you click on the layer mask button, it keeps whatever you have selected and hides the rest. We want to do the opposite. The way we do that is hold down the Option or Alt key. When you click on the Add Layer Mask button, it automatically does the opposite. See how it hid the church and everything else. So now I just have to click on my original thumbnail. If I take my lasso tool and we'll just select this area, go to Content Aware Fill and click OK. And look at that, it did a really good job because now it doesn't have the church to pick from. So now if we go to this other side, I'm gonna zoom out just a little bit to make sure I get a decent selection here. Just pop around here and content aware fill. Click OK. And again, does a pretty good job. Probably could use a bit of work in here, but you can see overall, it's pretty good. And then the final step is simply throw away the layer mask and delete it, and there we go. We've got the parts filled in we needed, but we didn't have to worry about content-aware fill using the wrong spot. So as I said, in this case, I would just fix up these areas with maybe a clone stamp or something like that, just to make it look good. But I think you'll agree, very simple and effective technique to make content-aware fill work even better. So if you ever have that problem where you try content-aware fill, no matter what you do, it just keeps picking those wrong areas, just consider temporarily adding a layer mask to hide those areas, and then once you're finished using content-aware fill, throw away the layer mask and you're good to go. Hopefully that helps you in a future project when you run into this roadblock. I would love it if you would like and subscribe to my channel here, and if you have some Photoshop using friends, please share it with them, because the more people, the merrier. Come back next week and I'll talk about another similar topic of how we can use the patch tool for cases where content-aware fill doesn't do the job. The patch tool can be even better.